हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू योर फिजिक्स क्लास। दिस इज योर फिजिक्स टीचर। होप यू ऑल आर इन अ गुड कंडीशन। इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो यू हैव लर्न्ड अबाउट मैग्नेटिक फील्ड लाइंस एंड अर्थ्स मैग्नेटिक फील्ड, एंड यू हैव ऑल्सो लर्न्ड दैट हाउ अ मैग्नेटिक कंपस वर्क्स। नाउ टूडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद मेथड्स ऑफ मैग्नेटाइजेशन। बिफोर दैट देर इज अ इन्फो हब एंड समथिंग इज रिटन अबाउट मैग्नेटिक शील्डिंग। So what is magnetic shielding? We will learn. As we know that our planet, the Earth, has its own magnetic field, and this magnetic field provides a reference point to a magnetic compass. How it provides a reference point, or what is the meaning of this? As we know that if we keep a magnetic compass on the earth, then it directs the magnetic compass towards the geographical north-south direction. If this is the geographic north of the earth and this is the geographic south, then like a bar magnet, the earth's magnetic field aligns the magnetic compass in the geographic north or towards the magnetic south of earth, because we know that the magnetic south is just near to the geographic north of the earth. So it always directs the magnetic compass in this direction. That means it provides a basis for the measurement of the directions, for finding the directions. So it works as a reference point, or it provides as a reference point to the magnetic compass. But apart from this, it also shields us from the full impact of the solar wind. What is solar wind? The wind which is coming from the sun, that is solar wind, and it has the charged particles emitted from the sun. So this magnetic field of the earth provides a shield for us, or it shields us from the solar wind, which is having the charged particles emitted from the sun, and these are also having the harmful rays along with it. So how it protects us, or how it shields us? Because as we know that the charged particles which are coming from the sun, they are in motion, they are flowing. So due to motion, they will also have some magnetic field associated with them. The solar winds will have the magnetic fields associated with them. So the magnetic field of the earth deflects the solar wind, and it will not allow to reach us. How it deflects? For example, if this is the sun, and from the sun the solar wind is coming, then the earth's magnetic field deflects this solar wind, because the solar wind is also magnetized, or it has some magnetic field. So it deflects, or it repels the solar wind, and it will not allow to reach us on the earth. So it helps us, or it shields us from the full impact of the solar wind, which is having the charged particles along with the harmful rays. So otherwise it would bombard us with the harmful rays, or it can hit us with the harmful rays. So in this way it protects us, and this method is known as the magnetic shielding. Now come to the methods of magnetization. So what is magnetization? Magnetization is the process of magnetizing a magnetic material from a magnet. It is known as magnetization, or simply the process by which we can convert a piece of metal or magnetic material into a magnet is known as magnetization. So there are three or four methods for magnetizing a magnetic material. First is the touch methods, and these are classified as two: single touch method and double touch method. The third one is the method by magnetization by induction, and the fourth one is the magnetization through electrical method. So we will learn about all this one by one. First is the single touch method. So what is done in the single touch method? In single touch method, we will take a soft iron bar or soft iron material, and we will keep that soft iron bar over the table. Then we will take a bar magnet. We know that it has two poles, south pole and north pole. So what we will do in this method, we will strike this iron bar, we will strike or touch or hit this iron bar with the bar magnet from one direction to the another, or from one end to the other end, like this. This, if this is a bar, iron bar, soft iron bar, we will start touching or stroking the iron bar with this bar magnet, starting from one end in this direction to the other end B, then again starting from A to B and by one end of the bar magnet. Here you can see we have taken the north pole of the bar magnet and this is the south pole. So with the one pole of the magnet, we will start touching or striking or hitting the soft iron bar from one end to the other end, like this, starting from A to B, then again from A and going to B, and again from A to B. In this way, we will touch this iron bar with the bar magnet. So we will repeat this process 10 to 12 times, and after some time we will see that the iron bar will become magnetized. How we can check that it has become magnetized? We can test the magnetic properties of the soft iron bar using the iron filings. Iron filings are just the small pieces of iron. So when we bring the iron filings close to this iron bar, then they will get attracted towards the two ends of the iron bar. Why these are attracted towards the two ends of the iron bar? Because it has become magnetized and it has acquired the two poles, which are termed as north pole and south pole, like a magnet. Now, how we can say that this is a north pole and this is a south pole? Because we are stroking this soft iron bar with the north pole of this bar magnet, then what happens that the domains or the small magnets which are present inside the soft iron bar, they will repel the north pole of the magnets, the small magnets which are present inside the magnetic material are known as domains. So they are also having the south and north pole. So whenever we are stroking the soft iron bar with the north pole, then the north of these domains will be repelled by this north pole of the bar magnet. So in this way, this pole will be the south pole and this pole will be the north pole and this will be the south pole. So in this way, the soft iron bar will get magnetized. So this is the magnetized bar, you can see. Now we will learn about the double touch method. So this is the single touch method. This method is known as the single touch method. So before that, something is written here, that instead of north pole of the bar magnet, strike the iron with south pole of the bar magnet, find out the difference. So what could be the difference? The difference will be that if we are stroking the soft iron bar with the south pole of the bar magnet, then what happens? This pole will become the south pole and this pole will become the north pole, just like that. This has been shown. This is for the case when we are striking it with the south pole of the magnet. Here the figure is shown for some other reason, and the right thing is that if we are striking or stroking it with the south pole of this bar magnet, then this pole of the soft iron will become as south pole and this will become as north pole. So this is the single touch method. Next is the double touch method. So in the double touch method, we will use the two bar magnets and again we will use the soft iron bar. So what we will do, firstly we will take two bar magnets and we will place them on the table with the opposite polarities, that means south of one magnet and the north pole of the other bar magnet. This is the south pole and this is the north pole of the other bar magnet. Then we will place the iron bar over these two magnets which are having the opposite polarities. So after that, we will take the another two bar magnets and we will place the opposite ends, like this is the north pole and this is the south pole of one magnet, and this is the opposite end, which is the north, and this is the south of the other magnet. So we will take the two bar magnets and a flat iron bar AB, and we will place the opposite poles of these two bar magnets at the center of this iron bar. C is the center of this iron bar. Now we will start dragging the magnets towards the opposite direction over the iron bar, such that the north pole moves towards the end B, such that the north pole moves towards the end B along the length, and vice versa. What is it? Means if it is the south pole and it is the north pole, then we will move these two bar magnets in the opposite directions. That means the A bar magnet with the south pole touching the soft iron core in this direction and the north pole of this magnet will be dragged in this direction. So we will repeat this process again and again, and after some time we will see that when we are dragging these two magnets in the opposite direction, then the magnet or the soft iron bar, the soft iron bar will get magnetized. After some time we can check the magnetic properties of the iron bar by using the iron filings. When we bring the iron filings near the two poles of the bar magnet, the soft iron core, the soft iron bar, then what happens? The iron filings will be attracted towards the ends of this iron bar, and because we know that the two ends will behave like the two poles of the magnet, but which pole will be the north pole or south pole? This pole will be the north pole and this pole will be the south pole. The poles or the polarities of the soft iron bar will be the opposite as that of the bar magnets or of the pole which is striked over the soft iron bar, because this is the south pole which we are striking. So this pole will be the north pole and this is the north pole which we are striking in the opposite direction. So this pole will be the south pole. So this method is known as the double touch method. So here side A will become, or the end A will become as the north pole of the iron bar, and the side B will become the south pole. So this is the double touch method. Now next is the method by magnetization by induction. So what is the magnetization by induction method? Induction means the acquiring of magnetic properties by a material or magnetic material when it is kept close, not in contact, when it kept close to a magnet or near a magnet, then that method is known as induction. What is induction? It is the process of acquiring the magnetic properties by a magnetic material when it is kept near to a magnet is known as induction, or this is also known as magnetic induction. This process is known as magnetic induction. So what is it? For example, let us take a bar magnet which is having the north and south poles. I have drawn like this, and we take some paper clips or iron filings. When we take some paper clips or iron filings, these will be attracted towards this bar magnet. So what happens that if we bring another iron filings or the paper clips near to these iron filings or paper clips, then these will also attracted towards this iron filings. So why? Because as we know that this is a bar magnet and it can attract these magnetic material, that can be iron filings or paper clips. But now these magnetic materials has also become magnetized, or these paper clips has also become magnetized because of the magnetic field of this bar magnet. So it can, these can also attract the another paper clips towards itself. So this process is known as magnetic induction. Why it is possible? This is because under the influence of the magnet, any magnetic material can also start behaving like a magnet. So this method is known as magnetic induction. So we can also understand this with the help of the activity. In this activity, we need a bar magnet, an iron nail, few paper clips, a wooden stand with a clamp. Simply, this is needed for suspending the iron nail. So in here we have taken a long iron nail and we have clamped it into a wooden stand in this manner, such that the tip of the iron nail is above the base of the wooden stand. Now we will place some paper clips at the bottom of the wooden stand near the tip of the iron nail. Then we will see that whether this iron nail can attract the paper clips. No, it cannot attract, because it is not a magnet, so it cannot attract the paper clips towards itself. But when we brought a bar magnet near to it, not in contact, we are not touching the bar magnet with it. When we brought a bar magnet near to it, near to the tip of this iron nail, then what happens? It will attract some paper clips towards itself. So why it happens? It is because that it has acquired the magnetic properties due to magnetic induction, because when we have kept it close, then due to the magnetic influence, then iron nail will also start behaving like a magnet and it can attract the paper clips towards itself. But when we move it away from the iron nail, then it will again get demagnetized and the paper clips will no longer be attracted to the iron nail and these will fall down. So in this way we can say that the iron nail can act as a magnet for some time under the influence of a magnet, and this method is known as, or this process is known as, magnetic induction. So now let's come to the next method, the magnetization through electrical method. So how magnetization is done? For this we can take any of the magnetic material, that can be a soft iron bar or a steel. What is the difference between soft iron bar and steel? Actually, soft iron bar we are taking, that will be a weak magnet, and the steel can be a strong magnet. Ye ek weak magnet hoga aur wo kya hoga, ek strong magnet hoga. Why it would be a weak magnet? Because it is just a soft iron bar and it cannot retain the magnetic properties for a longer period. But hard magnetic materials such as steel can retain their magnetic properties for a longer period of time. So that will be a strong magnet. So what has been done in this case? What is it? Firstly, we will take a soft iron bar. I can explain the process by drawing a diagram. We will take a soft iron bar. This is a soft iron bar. And over the soft iron bar, we will wind the insulated copper wire. We will give the windings of the insulated copper wire over the soft iron core. Means ki humne ek wire liye, jiski ki humne is tarah se turns kar diye over the soft iron core. And these are the two ends of this soft copper wire, the insulated copper wire. This is the other end. We have winded this copper wire or the insulated copper wire over the soft iron core. These are the two ends of the copper wire, and the two ends of the copper wires are connected to the two terminals of a battery. This is a battery which is having the two terminals, positive terminal and negative terminal, because a battery is made up of combination of cells. A cell is represented by a positive terminal and the smaller one representing the negative terminal. So what happens that when the switch is on, here we will connect a switch also. So when the switch is on, then what happens? So a current will flow from the positive terminal of the battery to the negative terminal by passing through the copper windings also, like this. The arrow will represent the direction of the current. Yahan se current jayega is tarah se. It will move like this, and it again flowing through the windings, it will come to the negative terminal of the battery. So in this way the current will flow through the copper windings, and when current flows through the circuit, then the soft iron core will behave like a magnet. So this type of magnet is known as the electromagnet. This type of magnet is known as the electromagnet, that when the current is passed through the coil means this copper wire which is wound around the soft iron core, then the iron bar will get magnetized, and this type of magnet is known as electromagnet. But this iron bar can retain its magnetic power only as when the current is switched on in the circuit. It can retain its magnetic power as long as the current is flowing through the insulated copper wire. But when the current is switched off, it loses its magnetic properties immediately. Means ki itni der tak hi इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेट की तरह बिहेव करेगा या मैग्नेट की तरह बिहेव करेगा जितनी देर तक इसमें से करंट पास कर रहे हैं. बट जब भी हम करंट को ऑफ कर देंगे, देन इमीडिएटली इट विल लूज इट्स मैग्नेटिक प्रॉपर्टीज एंड अगेन इट विल गेट डीमैग्नेटाइज्ड. सो दिस टाइप ऑफ मैग्नेट विल बी अ टेम्पररी मैग्नेट बिकॉज इट लूजेस इट्स मैग्नेटिक प्रॉपर्टीज व्हेन द करंट इज स्विच्ड ऑफ. सो दिस टाइप ऑफ मैग्नेट फॉर्म्ड विल बी अ टेम्पररी मैग्नेट एंड दिस इज नोन एज द इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेट. नाउ the magnetic strength of this electromagnet can be changed or it can be altered, because it depends upon the three factors. First is the number of windings of the insulated copper wire. What is the meaning of this insulated? Insulating means which is protected from heat, cold, और नॉइस बाय सराउंडिंग्स विद इंसुलेटिंग मटेरियल्स, मीन्स कि किसी भी मटेरियल से हमने इसको इंसुलेट किया हुआ है। हम वायर्स को इंसुलेट इसलिए करते हैं सो दैट वी कैन नॉट कम इन डायरेक्ट कॉन्टेक्ट विद द वायर्स एंड वी कैन डू नॉट गेट अ शॉक, इलेक्ट्रिकल शॉक। सो फर्स्ट थिंग दैट द मैग्नेटिक स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ एन इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेट डिपेंड्स अपॉन द नंबर ऑफ वाइंडिंग्स ऑफ द इंसुलेटेड कॉपर वायर। मोर द नंबर ऑफ वाइंडिंग्स मोर विल बी द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेट दस फाउंड। जितनी ज्यादा नंबर ऑफ वाइंडिंग्स होंगी उतना ही ज्यादा स्ट्रॉगर क्या होगा इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेट। यहाँ पर मैंने कम वाइंडिंग्स शो की है। अगर ज्यादा नंबर ऑफ वाइंडिंग्स होगी सॉफ्ट आयरन कोर के ऊपर इस तरह से, तो करंट फ्लो जो करेगा ज्यादा नंबर ऑफ टर्न्स में से करेगा, सो दैट देर विल बी मोर मैग्नेटिक फील्ड। ओके, देर विल बी मोर मैग्नेटिक फील्ड, सो द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेट विल बी मोर। नेक्स्ट, इट डिपेंड्स अपॉन द मटेरियल टू बी मैग्नेटाइज्ड। बिकॉज मटेरियल मैंने आपको बताया कि जैसे सॉफ्ट आयरन है और एक हो सकता है स्टील, ठीक है। हमने लिया सॉफ्ट आयरन बार, सो दैट इज वेरी वीक मैग्नेटिक मटेरियल। बट इफ यू टेक स्टील इन प्लेस ऑफ द सॉफ्ट आयरन बार, देन दैट विल बी अ हार्ड मैग्नेटिक मटेरियल। दैट आर टर्म्ड एज हार्ड मैग्नेटिक मटेरियल बिकॉज दे कैन रिटेन देयर मैग्नेटिक प्रॉपर्टीज इवन फॉर आफ्टर फ्यू मिनट्स व्हेन द करंट इज स्विच्ड ऑफ। हार्ड मैग्नेटिक मटेरियल्स आर स्ट्रांगली मैग्नेटाइज्ड एंड कैन समटाइम्स रिटेन देयर मैग्नेटिक प्रॉपर्टीज फॉर फ्यू मिनट्स इवन आफ्टर द करंट इज स्विच्ड ऑफ। सो वी कैन ऑल्सो यूज स्टील फॉर मेकिंग द स्ट्रांग इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेट्स and which is a hard material, hard magnetic material, and it can retain its magnetic properties for a longer period of time even after the current is switched off. Next is the amount of current flowing through the copper wire. The magnetic strength of an electromagnet depends upon the amount of current flowing through the copper wire. More the current, more will be the strength of the electromagnet. So these are the factors which determines the magnetic strength of an electromagnet, and this method is known as magnetization through electrical method. So I hope you will understand these topics. Thank you to all of you.